In this video, we'll go over the three types of images when it comes to alternative text, and when an alt attribute should be empty. Check out our other videos on alternative text, including an introduction to it and four tips to writing great alternative text. You can also get the article version of this content and other resources below. Let's get into it. When it comes to alternative text, there are three types of images. The first are informative images. These provide content and need alternative text near the image or in an HTML alt attribute. For example, let's say I was writing content about university life on campus and was talking about popular spots on campus. I used this image to show the quad. In this image, we see students running, we see that it's an open grassy area, and that it's next to a building. Either in text near the image or in an HTML alt attribute, I need to describe the image because it's adding content about what this popular spot looks like, what students do at it, and what buildings it is next to. My alternative text in the alt attribute can also depend on what content is already on the page. Let's say the web page content already described that the quad is a grassy area next to the old main building. My alt attribute might then just need to be students running on the quad. The next type of images are decorative images. These don't add any content to the page. Their only purpose is visual appeal. Whether an image is decorative or not is up to the author of the page, so it's important to consider if the image is adding any content. A good way to think about it is to ask yourself if the image adds any content to the existing narrative of the page. For example, this page is a university admissions page, so the page narrative is applying to the university. The designers used an image of two young adults laying on the grass looking at their phone. If we were to describe this image, the alternative text would literally be something like, two happy young adults looking at their phones on the grass. This doesn't add to the admissions narrative. The image is simply eye candy to make the page look better. All decorative images still need an empty alt attribute, so assistive technologies skip over them. The last type are functional images. These are images that do something, like linked images. They need alternative text nearby or in an alt attribute that's a description of the image and makes it clear where the link goes. As an example, let's look at a team or faculty page with everyone's picture on it. The pictures are linked and go to the person's about page. The alternative text in the alt attribute for these could be about Lisa Lewis, or whoever the person's name is. Now you might be wondering if the person's name below the image could be the alternative text. It can be, but only under certain conditions, which we'll talk about next. So let's jump right into when the HTML alt attribute can be empty, starting with when a functional image can have an empty alt attribute. Remember, all images have to have an alt attribute, but there are times when the alt attribute should be empty, so the screen reader doesn't announce the image. Now this is the most complex we'll get with alternative text, so bear with me through this example. A functional image can have an empty alt attribute when the image and text are wrapped in the same HTML link or ahref attribute. Let's look at the team member linked image example. If we look at the HTML code, we see the ahref wraps around the image and the paragraph with the name. This connects the image with the text, so the alt attribute can be empty. The screen reader will say something like, "Link Lisa Lewis" out loud, which describes the image and provides enough context about where it will go. So in this case, the link text below the image can be the alternative text because the image and text are wrapped in the same ahref attribute. Now, if the image and text each have their own link or their own ahref, like in this code here, the image would need an alt attribute even though it would sound repetitive with the screen reader. If the image didn't have an alt attribute, the screen reader would announce a link and might read the image file name or something else unhelpful. So if you can, you should always try to wrap the ahref around the image and text, so it isn't as repetitive for folks using assistive technologies. Nice! That's as advanced as we get with alternative text in these videos. The other times your images can have an empty alt attribute is when the alternative text is already on the page near the image, and when the image is purely decorative. Great, you're ready for the 4 tips to writing great alternative text.